Good morning, students. Welcome to the lecture of Pre-Level Analysis 2. In the last lecture, we have started studying the basic, which are essential to understand this Liebig major theory. We have started with the definition of set, subset. We have seen the operations such as union, intersection, difference, symmetric difference, etc. Then we had a look on distributive laws, De Morgan's laws. Then we have said by assuming curly set to be the collection of disjoint sets, we have written the De Morgan's laws for arbitrary union and intersection. Similarly, we have written the distributive laws for the arbitrary union and intersection. Then we have discussed what is countable set, right? Then countable, uncountable relation we have seen, right? Then the last point we have started is the relation. Relation is actually a subset of a Cartesian product of the two sets A and B, that is R is a subset of A cross B, and these are the properties: reflexive, symmetric, antisymmetric, transitive, partial order relation, and equivalence relation also we have seen. Okay, now let me just take some examples. Actually, one example we have discussed by taking the friendship between the students of MSc 1 class, right? No? Now in today's lecture, let us discuss some examples in mathematics so that the idea will be very clear to all of you. Okay, let me start with two sets A and B, and we will find a relation, what kind of relations we can form, and we will check which are the properties possessed by those relations. Therefore, let me start with this example. One student has requested me to elaborate this relation in detail. That's why we are taking this. Okay, let me go for an example. Say for two sets, I will consider set A to be some 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, what about set B? Let me write this as some 4, 6, 8, and 9. These are the two non-empty sets under the consideration. Now we want to write a relation, say R, between the two sets. Okay, no doubt this R is going to be a subset of A cross B. How many elements do we have in this partition product A and B? There are 4 elements in A, 4 elements in B. But how many elements are there in A cross B? Students?
16
elements. Good. We were going to write one element A. We'll take one element of A, say 2, and we'll make a pair with all the remaining elements of B, right? No? 4, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 9. Okay? Likewise, we have to write for the remaining. 3, 4, 2, 6, 3, 8, 3, 9. Then 4, 4, 6, 4, 8, 4, 9. And the last 4 elements are 5, 4, 5, 6. Related to B. No doubt this A is in capital A and this B is in capital B. If A is divisor of B. What a simple, very simple relation we have taken. If A is divisor of B, then A is related to B is the relation we are going to do. Therefore, what will be my set R? Okay, among these pairs, okay, this is generalized as AB. We were going to say A is related to B only if A is a divisor of B. A divides B. Alright? So you just tell me how many elements I take in this relation. First element, whether it will be there, 2, 4. Whether this 2 is related to 4 or not. With this relation, A is divisor of B.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, it is. What about 2, 6? 2 divide 6, therefore this is also there. Next 2 divide 8, correct na? This element will not be there, right na? 2, 9, because 2 doesn't divide there. What for 3, 4? Not there. What for 3, 6? Yes, it is there. 3, 8, not. the prenine is there. Okay. Next, whether copper is there in the relation?
In the yes, ma'am.
Yes, it is. What for 4-6? Not there.
No.
4-8?
Yes.
Yes, it is. What for 4-9? It's not there again. 5-4 is not there. 5-6 is not there. 5-8 is not there. Right? No. 5-9 is also. Yes or no? Correct? These are the units are not there. Because this is the relation we have defined. Is that okay? This is what
yes,
the
ma'am.
Relation, which is a subset of your Cartesian product, A cross B. Which is a subset of A cross B. Now one can check whether it possesses the reflexive property. Whether this relation possesses a reflexive property. What is reflexive property we have discussed? An element is related to itself. No, no doubt this is for all A in the given set. Whether 2-2 is there? 2-2 is there. It's not there.
No, ma'am.
This is not reflexive. Likewise, you can check the remaining properties also. Okay. Let me take another example. Relation R defined on Z, Y. A related to B, we can relate A minus B is even. Okay, what we were writing? A relation R defined on Z, Z is the set of integers. Y, A related to B, if and only if A minus B is even. Correct? Now, what about this relation for every AB in Z? Now, we will check the properties for every AB in Z. Okay. What kind of relation this is going to possess? Whether it is going to possess reflexive property? Whether the relation is reflexive? If I take an element A in Z, we want to check whether A is related to A. To check A is related to A, what one should check? A minus A is 0. No? Therefore, one can say it is even. Therefore, the relation is reflexive. The relation is reflexive. What about symmetric property? A related to B is given to us. Whether it will imply B related to A? Actually, A related to B implies an implied by A minus B is even. Correct? Right? No? Now, whether B is related to A now, in this case? Yes, if A minus B is even, what about B minus A? Is it even or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Though, suppose this A minus B is positive, even, or positive integer, which is even. Then what about B minus A? It will be negative, but still it will be even, no? Therefore, may I say B minus A is also even? Here we were not bothering about positive and negative values. Okay, if this is positive, this is going to be negative, right? If A minus B is negative, well, this is going to be positive. We are not bothering about the nature or sign. Therefore, may I say B is related to A? What kind of relation this is? Is it symmetric? Yes, no? The relation is symmetric. Now, we want to check whether the relation is antisymmetric. Let us check. A related to B, B related to A. What both is giving us? A minus B and B minus A, both even. Right, no? But whether this both even gives you the conclusion that A is equal to B. Is it true?
No, ma'am.
No, it is not. Therefore, the relation is not antisymmetric. Correct. Okay? The relation is not antisymmetric. Let us check transitivity. What transitivity says? A is related to B, B is related to C. What this is going to imply? A minus B and B minus C both are even. Right? No? Now what about their addition? Addition of two even.
even.
For a minus b plus b minus c is even, which is going to give us an idea. A minus c is also even. Now, if a minus c is even, what it is going to tell us that a is related to c. Therefore, what kind of relation this is? Is it transitive? The relation is transitive. Okay. Understood relations with an examples in mathematics. Okay. Let me write one more example. A is divisor of b, but in a broad sense of natural number sequencing. Okay. A relation R defined on n. What is n? Set of natural numbers. Set of natural numbers by A related to B if and only A is divisor of. The same we have taken in the first example, but the first example is a very small and finite example. Now we were going to define this on the set of natural numbers. Now you have to tell me how many properties this relation is going to possess. Whether the relation is reflexive?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Why? Because
every element itself divides
itself. Therefore, A is related to A. For every A in N, every element divides itself. Therefore, A is related to A. Therefore, the relation is reflexive. Okay. Let us check the next one. Symmetric. Whether symmetricity holds, if A is divisor of B, whether it implies B is divisor of A?
No, ma'am.
No, therefore the relation is not symmetric. Correct, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
A divides B does not imply B divides A. Next, let me check antisymmetricity. What is antisymmetric property? A related to B, B related to A implies A is equal to B. Let us check. A related to B means what? A divides B. B related to A means B divides A. If both elements are going to divide one another, what is your conclusion?
A equal to plus or minus B.
Plus minus B, actually. Therefore, can I say it is equal to B also? It
yes,
is one of the possibilities. Therefore, the relation is anti-symmetry. Okay. Next, let us check whether it is transitive. What should I check for transitivity? A related to B, B related to C should imply A related to C. This we have to check. Okay. Now, A related to B means what? A divides. B related to C means what? B divides C. Will it imply A divides C? A is dividing
yes,
B,
ma'am.
A is
yes,
dividing
ma'am.
C, which implies A divides C. Therefore, the relation is reflexive, anti-symmetric and transitive. But what kind of relation it is? RAT. Is it partial order relation? This is partial order relation. What for the previous one we have seen? R, S and T, no? Because there is
equivalence.
Yes, this is equivalence. Okay? The two relations we have seen. Partial ordered relation and equivalence relation. Then what for the partially ordered set? What is partially ordered set? Coset we are saying it, no? Coset. This is also called as coset, partially ordered set. Okay, what is partially ordered set? A set on which a partial ordered relation is defined. Correct? A relation R on a non-empty set X is said to be partial ordered. I'm generating partial organization. Okay, partial organization with RH, replacement, anti-symmetric and trans. Okay, a set X equipped with partial order relation. Partial order relation R is said to be partial order set. Post set I can write. Okay. Let us discuss the examples of a post set. Now here I will take first example set of natural number with less than or equals to. Okay. Where is A less than or equals to B means A is divisor of B. This is a notation, okay? Less than or equals to doesn't mean that it is always less or equal to B. This is a notation for the relation. You have to keep this in mind, notation of relation. Then what this relation, notation relation denotes? This denotes that A is divisor of B. Just now we have seen this example, no? And with A is a divisor of B. Instead of capital R, it was taken a symbol to be less than or equal to. Now whether this is a partial ordered set, the relation we have checked out is to be a partial ordered relation. Therefore, may I say this is a post set? Correct, no? This is a post set. Right? Let me take another example. Let capital F be family of sets. And the set inclusion is the relation. The set inclusion is a relation. Now we want to check whether this family of sets P is a partial ordered relation so that F will be a partially ordered set. Yes. Inclusion. You can write like this also. Subset. Whether this relation is reflexive, whether any set is a subset of itself, A contained in it. If I take say A is the element of the set F, that is A itself is a set, whether A contained in A is true or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Therefore the relation is reflexive. Correct. Now what should I check next? Anti-symmetric I want to check. What for anti-symmetry? Let me take two sets in the set family of sets A and B. And now we were writing A is in B and B is in A. What this implies? A is equal to B, na?
Yes, ma'am.
A is contained in B, B is contained in B. What is the relation? Anti-symmetric. This is reflexive. This is anti-symmetric. Third, let me check for any three sets A, B, C in the family of sets. Let me write A is contained in B, B is contained in C. Whether it implies A is contained in C? Yes, it is. Therefore, the relation is transitive. Therefore, whatever this inclusion relation is partial order relation. Partial order relation, right? Therefore, may I say, yeah, with this inclusion is OSE. Yeah, with this inclusion relation is a OSE. Okay, let us come to next definition. The next partially ordered set we have seen. Now we are going to see what is strict order relation. Okay, next is strict order relation. Now what this strict order relation is going to tell us? The relation which satisfies only anti-symmetricity and transitivity is called as strict relation. A relation capital R on set X is said to be strict order relation if it is anti-symmetric and transitive. Transitive. Okay, this is another form of strict relation. Next concept comes to be a comparable elements. Do anyone know what is comparable elements? So that we can move towards a totally ordered set. Okay, the elements are said to be comparable if one of them is related to the other. What I'm saying, if one of them is related to other. Let me write a definition. Two elements A and B in a coset are said to be comparable if one of them is related to other. One of them is related to other. That is, either A related to B or B related to A. Or in that less equal symbol, A is less than or equals to B or B is less than or equals to A. Must hold. One of them should hold. Then only one can say these elements are comparable elements. Let us check that previous first example we have taken in today's lecture. Yes. What for this 2, 4? 2, 4, one can say that 2 related to 4. Or in terms of less equal symbol, this is 2 less equal by 4. But what for 2, 9? May I say 2 is not less equal by 9? Correct, na? This 2 related to 4, right? Or in less equal symbol, one can say 2 less than or equal. But here we know that 2 is not related to 9, correct? 2 is not related to 9, therefore I can write 2 is not less than or equal. These two elements are not related to one another. Then these two are not said to be not comparable elements. These are said to be not comparable elements. Okay. Now we are moving towards the total ordered set. What is total ordered set? A coset in which every elements are comparable. Okay. A coset in which any two elements are comparable. These notions are very easy to understand in major theory, okay? Though you feel that these are very simple concepts, I am telling you. But just pay attention, okay? The two elements are comparable, is called totally ordered. Totally ordered set, or also it is called as a chain. Why it is called as a chain? See, for example, if we have a set X to be a totally ordered set. Okay. Then what this condition says? That any two elements are comparable. Let me impose the relation is less than or equals to, or notation. Therefore, what kind of relation it is? This is partial ordered relation. Right. Now let us write a partial ordered relation in which any two elements are comparable. Therefore, let us start with the first element. See, let me denote the elements in this set to be x1, x2, and so on, xn, so on. Okay. So for x1 related to x2, x2 related to x3, x3 related to x4, and so on. Somewhere it is related to xn and is going to continue. Why? Because any two elements are comparable. For the sake of convenience, I have written that x1 related to x2, x2 related to x3, and so on. So what kind of formation it is? This is one kind of chain going to form, right? All these elements are related to one another. That's why the another name for the total ordered set is chain. It is look like a chain. This is going to look like a chain. Okay, understood what is totally ordered set?
Yes, ma'am.
So the first example which we have seen is not totally ordered, this one. because here we have to check whether all elements are comparable. Here some elements are not comparable. Okay, any difficulty up to this set, coset, equivalence, relation, partial order relation, strict order relation? You can ask. Otherwise, we will move towards the next concept of finding an upper bound and upper. What is bounded set? Whether I have taken this revision in real Riemann integration theory? Bounded
set? Yes, ma'am.
Lower bound is going to exist. Why this is the greatest among all lower bound? I think we have taken this. But we will not give much time on this. Let us see what the set S, when it is said to be bounded, if it has both the bounds, right now, lower bounded, upper bound, or the set is said to be bounded if it has, if it is bounded below and bounded above, right? So if I consider this to be a set, one can say mod of X is less than or equals to M for some M positive, for all X in S. This is the definition, right? No? Can anyone tell me why we were finding greatest among all the lower bounds and least among all the upper bounds? If I have taken this already, you must know this. Lower bound, why we were finding greatest of lower bounds, least of upper bounds. Just take an example again. Simple example to discuss. I am discussing always. Suppose this is a real line on which I am considering the set to be open interval 1 to 2. Now you have to tell me whether the set is bounded.
Yes, ma'am.
What is upper bound?
2.
Is it unique?
No, ma'am, it is not unique, but the set of upper bounds has least member 2.
Good. What is upper bound then? Can you tell me the set of upper bounds?
Closed 2 to open infinity.
Good. Closed 2 to open infinity. And here, one can find out the least element, right now? Why this is so? Because the set of upper bound is bounded below. Set of upper bound is bounded below. Correct, na? As it is bounded below, one can find out the least element. Okay. Therefore, we were finding least upper bound. We were finding least upper bound, LUB in short, or we were writing this as supremum. Okay. Why there is a need to go for this upper bound or least upper bound? Because maximum concept or least element or greatest element we cannot find in the set. No? Can you find the greatest element of the set itself?
No, ma'am.
Element kutla hai ya interval mein. You cannot answer, right? That's why there is a need to define an upper bound concept. And after finding upper bound concept, the mathematicians have found that these upper bounds are not unique. That's why it comes to finding the least, so that the value is unique. Therefore, what about lower bounds similarly? Set of lower bounds.
Minus infinity to 1.
Yes, this is minus infinity to closed 1, right? This set is, that is bounded above. As it is bounded above, one can find out the greatest, right? Therefore, what this is called as?
GLB.
Greatest lower bound. That is GLB, and it is also called as infimum. It is also called as infimum. Now the next definition comes with the bounded set. Next we can define this to be a set. Ordered set is an order complete. It is said to be. Just a minute, I think I'm forgetting something. Ordered set I'm forgetting. Let me come to ordered set. Yes, what is ordered set? Totally ordered or ordered set rather. Totally ordered or ordered set. One and the same thing. Means again, a partial ordered relation is equal on set X is said to be linear order. I think these words you have heard, na? Linear order or totally ordered. Just now we have seen totally ordered. Linear order, total order, if any two elements are comparable. Any two elements are comparable under. Okay, therefore, whatever the set is, the set X, together with this relation is called as ordered set. The set X together with linear order. Together with a linear order is called ordered set. Order or linearly ordered or totally ordered and next it comes with order complete. That is the number 19. Okay, now an ordered set is said to be ordered complete. Ordered set X with less than or equals to X less than or equals to is said to be order complete. Is said to be order complete if every non-empty set, sorry, subset, every non-empty subset of X which has upper bound has least upper bound. Right? Or equivalently, if every non-empty subset is order complete, okay? Every non-empty subset of X which has lower bound and greatest lower bound. Okay, existence of an upper bound gives the existence of least upper bound, and existence of lower bound gives the existence of greatest lower bound. Then the set is said to be a order complete set. Okay, we will stop for today. Actually, if you have difficulties, you can ask me. If not, let us stop here. Thank you for being with me for this today's lecture.